On this episode, I'm sick and tired of getting made fun of.
No, she's not.
So I've been wanting to do this video for a really long time, and I'm just now getting around to doing it because every time I was going to do it, something happened. Today, I'm going to tell you, this is not like centered and it's bugging me. Okay, today I'm gonna tell you about dark meanings behind nursery rhymes.
They all have dark meanings.
Which is why I'm telling them about them. Okay, so the first one I'm gonna talk about is Humpty Dumpty. You know, Humpty Dumpty, I don't even remember. Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
I went to a website and it says, Humpty Dumpty was a name for a cannon protecting a fort that fell, according to military historians. In June 1648, Humpty Dumpty was stationed on the walls of Colchester, trying to keep Parliament's army from taking the city. A month later, Parliament's army damaged the walls under Humpty Dumpty, which led it to have a great fall. King's horses and King's men were the royalists, fighting in support of King Charles I. So, I guess...
That's not as dark as the version I heard.
There were like two versions, but I
just want to point out, it never once says that Humpty Dumpty is an egg like all the nursery rhymes depict. So the leading theory prior to what she just read, which I had never heard before, was that Humpty Dumpty was the name of an actual man. And when he fell off and cracked his head open, none of the doctors, none of the king's people could get his brains back in his skull and bring him back.
That's morbid. The little old lady that lived in a shoe. Now this one's kind of messed up. It's by Mother Goose. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread and whipped them all soundly and put them to bed. You know, just sounds like a mom who had a lot of kids and gave them broth and put them to bed.
So some super poor single mother with too many kids to take care of.
So obviously the mom had too many children and she didn't know what to do. I wouldn't know what to do if I even had one kid, so props to her. She became frustrated and whooped them. That's not good. And she didn't have enough money to feed them, so she gave them broth without any bread. And living in a shoe represented poverty, so they were really poor. But in the nursery rhymes, it's like a nice shoe.
No, it's not. It's like a rundown, beat-up boot.
You know, I'm trying to give it some optimism here that that's not actually what it meant.
Nursery rhymes were created to try and make horrible, horrible life problems seem not so bad to children. Give them an upbeat sound so that it doesn't make them want to kill themselves.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary. Mary, Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow with silver bells and cockle shells and pretty maids all in a row? Super old one is Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow with silver bells and cockle shells and so my garden grows. So people say that Mary is Bloody Mary, the Catholic Queen of England, and she filled the graveyards with Protestants. The garden that they're talking about in the nursery rhyme is actually the graveyard. The silver bells and cockle shells are instruments of torture. The maids is the original guillotine for mass executions. Another more common theory is that Mary Queen of Scots is the Mary, and the cockle shells and silver bells are the ornaments on a dress given to her by her first husband, the Dauphin of France. The maids in a row were her ladies in waiting. I mean, that's a lot nicer.
More than likely, it's about Bloody Mary because it's about murdering and torturing people and then throwing them in her graveyard.
Hush-a-bye, baby. Hush-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. Down will come, baby, cradle and all. It was written by a boy who sailed with the Pilgrim Fathers to America in 1620. Inspired by the Native American custom of popping babies' cradles in the branches of trees. So they just threw cradles into trees.
Now it's a tree branch.
Rock-a-bye baby, your cradle is green. Father's a nobleman, mother's a queen. Sally's a lady and wears a gold ring. Johnny's a drummer and drums for the king. Hush-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. Down will come baby, cradle and all.
So that one didn't have to be disturbing. They just added the thing about babies dying for giggles. So, like, it was common practice to hang the cradle in, like, the branch of a tree so that when the wind blew, it would rock the cradle and it'd be nice and easy. And then they just decided to go, oh, but when that branch breaks, your baby's gonna fall and die.
And probably the most famous one that I've ever heard is Ring Around the Rosie. You know, the Ring Around the Rosie, pocket full of posies, ashes, ashes, we all fall down. In this case, they're dying of the bubonic plague. It is about the 1665 Great Plague of London. And Rosie is a nasty rash you get on your skin. It's ring-shaped, and the filled pockets with posies, they're sweet-smelling herbs, since people believe the disease was transmitted by bad smells, and then the ashes are from the thousands of dead bodies they burned, because there were, like, so many bodies, they just started burning them.
The only way to effectively get rid of a disease is to destroy the source, and dead bodies were one of the major sources.
Jack and Jill. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jack came down and lost his crown.
Jack fell down and broke his crown.
Oh, I don't even remember these.
So Jack fell down and broke his crown, as in he fell down and cracked open his head.
And Jill came tumbling after. So Jack and Jill are two kids. Jill is not your right hand. One gets a horrible head injury, then the other falls down too. Some say it's about King Louis XVI, who was Jack. He was beheaded, so he lost his crown. And then Jill was Queen Mary Antoinette, and she came tumbling after. Okay, Baba Black Sheep is the last one. Baba Black Sheep, have you any wool?
Yes, sir, 3 bags full.
Is that it?
Full, one for the master, one for the dame, and one for the little boy who lives down the lane.
It's about the medieval wool tax from the 13th century by King Edward I. We don't like taxes. They didn't like them back then either. A third of the cost of a sack of wool went to him, another went to the church, and the last went to the farmer. That doesn't sound fair.
So they lost 66%.
There was nothing left for the little shepherd boy who lives down the lane. Black sheep were considered to be bad luck because their fleeces weren't able to be dyed and they were less appealing to the farmer. Let me know in the comments what your favorite nursery rhyme is. What you think is the most disturbing to your liking.
If you even think of a nursery rhyme, it probably has a disturbing origin.
So like and comment and subscribe if you like this video, and...
And if you didn't like it, do it anyway. There will be more.
And I will see you next time for another spooky dookie video.
I mean, technically they'll see us, we won't see them.
Well, you know what?